Welcome to Pro Hockey Bloops. I'm your host, Mark Hebscher. We're here at one of the world's largest sports collectible and memorabilia stores, Legends of the Game. And this place is fantastic. I mean, they got everything here. They got jerseys, they got cards, pictures, autographs, phenomenal stuff. In fact, I can hardly wait to run through here barefoot when this video is over. But for now, if you like action, then you're gonna love the hard hits, the wild collisions, the sensational goals, and more that we have to offer. Besides the great hockey action, we're also going to test your powers of recall with some trivia teasers. Also a segment known as You Make the Call. So if you're ready, I suggest you fasten your seatbelt, place your tray tables in the locked and upright position, kick off your shoes, and get ready to laugh. We'll begin with those masters of mayhem, those demolition dandies, the fighters. Come on, put them up. Oh! Time now for a little bit of trivia. Who was the youngest defenseman to score 30 goals in one season in the NHL? I'll have the answer for you in a couple of seconds. Think about it. But first, you make the call. Now you tell me, which one of these two fighters is going to go down first? Is it 22 in white or 25 in the dark jersey? You make the call. All right, and we'll roll it, and you will find out that the first guy to go down is, in fact...
A drum roll, please.
Is in fact, well, all of them. Time now for our trivia answer. The question again, who was the youngest defenseman to score 30 goals in a season? Well, he played for Buffalo, then was traded. His name? Phil Housley. He was 20 years of age in 83-84.
I love these hard-nosed hockey players. Chris Nyland. Huh? Brad Marsh, Cam Neely, Scott Stevens. Yes, sirree, if there's one thing hockey fans just love, absolutely adore, it's a good, clean check. No, not that kind of a check. I mean a body check, a violent collision between two padded warriors on blades. You know, our extremely lazy and vastly overpaid researchers spent hours in search of the best hits in pro hockey, and I'm happy to report that they've actually found several minutes worth. As well, we're going to take a closer look at the reactions of several coaches. And believe me, folks, you're going to get an earful from some of these. Also, we'll try to figure out why anybody in the world would want to be a hockey goalie. Okay, roll it, fellas, and pass the popcorn, okay?
couldn't sleep at all last night. Blankets on the floor, turn my pillow upside down. I never, never did before, because I was tossing and turning, and tossing, tossing and turning all night. Jumped out of bed, turned on the light. I pulled down the shade, went to the kitchen for a bite. Rolled up the shade, turned off the light. I jumped back into bed, it was the middle of the night. The clock downstairs was striking four. Couldn't get you off of mine. I heard the milkman at the door.
Both benches are on the same side of the ice. Why the coaches can get so close to each other? Here's Terry Crisp, who used to coach Calgary, but obviously got a little bit too excited for the job. Look, he's ranting and raving here. He wants to tell the referee that he missed the call and he should look into the camera. He says, look into that camera, open your eyes. Don Karski says, hey, Terry, we got a game to play. I don't have time for this nonsense here. Look into the camera and change your mind, okay? Buffalo's Rick Dudley. I got a plane to catch in 5 minutes. We're going into overtime. I don't believe it. Here's Jacques Demers trying to break away from his coaches to get at Herb Brooks. Yeah, come on. I'll kill you. Come on over here. I dare you. I dare you. You got to be a nut to be a goaltender, you know that. Here, Billy Smith. Hey, hey, ref, he touched me. He came by and touched me. That's got to be a penalty, right? And there's Ron Hextall saying, oh, darn it, I'm really upset now. Let me at him. Sometimes you just got to retaliate. There's Billy Smith saying, fine, you hit me, I hit you. And then there's the always embarrassing 70-footer that goes in and you just want to crawl into a hole. Here's Kelly Rudy of the LA Kings. He has no idea where the puck is. No idea. He's hoping that his teammates are going to fall on it, clear it, ice it, anything, because he just doesn't know where the puck is at all. Oh, those poor goaltenders. Time for another trivia question, folks. Here it is. Who was the only man to win the Vezina and Calder Trophy in the same season? That's the best goalie and top rookie. Let's see now. His brother was a good goal scorer. Oh, yeah. Tony Esposito, Chicago. You know, stuff from the 60s is worth a lot of money these days, especially hockey cards. Bobby Orr's 1966-67 rookie card worth about $1,500, in fact.
1500. Yeah. Let's go back a couple of decades now, and if you're like me, you'll remember the good old days of hockey with fondness. Men like Gump Worsley, Rogie Vachon, Bobby Hull, and of course, Bobby Orr. They were my favorites. And I distinctly remember the faces of these players as well. Of course, back then, they didn't wear helmets, and very few goalies wore face masks. Nowadays, of course, everybody has a helmet, and you really do need a program to tell the players apart. You know, those old days are long gone, but here on Pro Hockey Bloops, they're not forgotten. In fact, we're resurrecting an oldie but a goodie for you right now. So get out your love beads, light your incense, heck, grow your sideburns long for all I care. Just come on along for the ride. Now for another trivia question. You think you know hockey? Well, try this one on for size. Who is the oldest rookie in NHL history? We'll have the answer for you in a couple of seconds. But before that, another edition of You Make the Call. Back to the glory days. Boston Bruins. Here's Don Marcotte up the wing against the Rangers. Marcotte drops the puck for the great Bobby Orr. Stop it right there. Is he going to shoot or is he going to pass? You make the call. And we'll roll the video again and find out exactly what happens. Does the great Bobby Orr pass the puck to Don Marcotte, or does he shoot it? Here we go. Oh, a great pass to Marcotte. He shoots. He scores. If you said he would pass, you made the right call. Now for the answer to our trivia question. Have you thought about this one? Who was the oldest rookie in NHL history? Do you remember a fellow by the name of Connie Madigan? He was 38 years old when he played for St. Louis.
Well, those were the good old days, huh, when men were men and they all used wooden hockey sticks. Of course, nowadays, they use aluminum sticks, a good many of them. Wayne Gretzky, of course, was the pioneer of the aluminum stick. In fact, this is the first aluminum stick he ever used in the National Hockey League, worth, about $2,000. Pretty sharp, Wayne. You're a sharp cookie. But who's going to miss a $2,000 stick? Nobody. Now, remember at the beginning of the show when I told you about the fabulous components that you're going to see during Pro Hockey Bloops? Well, our crack staff set out on a Herculean mission of trying to compile all the elements of hockey into nice, neat segments. And they found some of the greatest goals ever scored in the history of hockey. They also found some of the greatest saves ever witnessed in the history of hockey. They found the finest fights, the funniest blunders, and then they erased them all by accident. So they came up to me and they said, Mark, we got a problem. We erased the tapes. I said, hey, no problem. These things happen. So after a real scare, here's what our folks put together before they were fired. We've got most of the original stuff. Well, we have some of the original stuff. Okay, we don't have any of the original stuff. But this is what happens when your staff deserts you.
it's not just the players who get involved in the action. No, it's the fans and the referees as well. On the ice, in the ice.
Ah, that feels good.
You know, hockey is a violent sport. Violent? Are you kidding me? How often do strippers come onto the ice?
Why don't we get you and your fellas together? We'll have a big old good time. We'll get together for a couple of drinks. We'll have something to eat. And then we'll have some fun. Yeah, you tell the guys.
Here's my number. You know, folks, fighting is an integral part of hockey. Now, this looks like your ordinary basic scrap, two teams going at it tooth and nail, but there's something a little bit different. See if you can't figure it out. Maybe a supplemental trivia question here. What's wrong? Here it is on the replay. Now, number 26 in white at the left of your screen gets into a scrap, but he's got no partner. What does he do? He grabs the guy that his teammate's fighting and says,
"Wait a minute, let me at him, I'll kill him! He said something about my sister! Let me break my knuckles on his helmet! I'll murder the guy!"
His poor teammate says, "Well, who am I gonna fight now, for gosh sake? What am I gonna do?" Now, watch this. Okay, the ref's not looking? Okay, I'll just give you a little shot right there. How about that, huh? You like that? Yeah, I'll give it to you. Good. Now, I've seen scrambles before, and you've seen scrambles before, but you ain't seen nothing until you've seen this scramble. Watch the poor goalie here. I got it. Oh, oh, no. Okay, clear it, clear it. Get rid of it. Uh-oh, here we go again. Phew, thank goodness I got the puck. Meeting of the minds along the boards? Yeah, how do you feel? Oh, I got my bell rung a bit, but I feel fine. Yes, hockey. Clobbering. Crashing. Even colliding. It's unavoidable on the ice. What's going on out there? Let's see a little search and destroy mission, huh? Come on, knock them down. Make it hurt. Earn your paycheck out there. And provide some entertainment for those of us viewing this video. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, Pray Tell Records presents 100 of hockey's greatest hits. Yes, you'll hear from the greatest hits of all time. Hits such as Touchin' and Squeezin', Hello Old Friend, Hit Me With Your Best Shot, and one of the all-time greatest hits, Goldmouth Blues. Yes, Pray Tell Records, 100 of hockey's greatest hits, available now in stores everywhere, as long as you can find it. This is Minnesota's Dave Mackey after being embroiled in a fight with Wendell Clark of Toronto. And you know what he's saying? He's saying, "Why did I fight Wendell Clark? Of all the guys, why did I fight him? He could have killed me. I got to give this game up, I'm telling you." Now, more hits coming right into your living room. The old two-for-one. Yeah, it looks like a 7-10 split there. Nice. There's Mr. Sutter knocking Mr. Kordick down. Luke Richardson and friends at Maple Leaf Gardens. Here goes Glenn Featherstone over the boards. Calgary's Joe Neuendijk says, "Hi, fellas, I don't want to use the gate." Byers and Bork of Boston. A couple of Oilers colliding. And a couple more Oilers colliding. A couple of Islanders, look out! And there's Mike McPhee tasting some boards and chomping on some ice. Hey, that was pretty good. Let's see some more hits. Okay, you got him. Gary Roberts of Calgary, down he goes. And that's not bad. You know, I wouldn't mind seeing some more hits. Yeah, okay, let's see what we can do. All right. Hey, don't hit the goaltender. Whatever you do, do not hit the goaltender, for gosh sakes. These aren't bad. I think we can see some more good hits. Not bad. Come on, these aren't even any good. I've seen better hits on other videos before. You guys are saving the good hits for the end, aren't you? Come on, let's see something decent out there. All right, you asked for it. Craig Simpson going down, and then Luke Richardson nailing Tony Granato. Hi, is this where I audition for the movie Slapshot? It isn't. Well, I'm looking like a fool then. Here's Ty Domi of Newmarket. Now, he doesn't score much, but when he does, he likes to celebrate. Yeah, attaboy, Ty. Now, let's show you some real good goal scorers. Here's Mark Lamb of Edmonton. Stéphane Richer of Montreal. And Toronto's Gary Lehman. Hey, don't worry about it, Bill, okay? So they scored 7 goals on you. Don't worry, we'll go out for a couple of drinks. We'll have a nice bite to eat. They'll be good as new tomorrow, okay? Okay, good. Hello, is this 976, babe? Yeah, is Samantha there? Hey, you tell that referee to keep his mind on the game and forget about the girls, okay? Hey, guys, stay away from me. I got whooping cough, I got mumps, I got chicken pox. You're gonna catch your death. Stay away from me, okay? Yeah, give me my doctor, will you? Dr. Doolittle. Okay, let's serve up some real hits on a silver platter for you. First up, Jay Wells on Mike McVie. Next, Jimmy Johnson against Vince Domfus. Calgary's Rick Natras misses by a mile. LA's Keith Crowder looking out for Jeff Bookaboom. Look out! Vancouver's Jim Sandlack meeting Luke Richardson of Toronto. Hey, Luke, how you doing? How's the family? Now, here's Tom Curvers of Toronto going after Detroit's Joey Koser. Only one way to get this guy to stay down. And, hey, Tom, aren't you getting a little bit too friendly there? I mean, you and Joey don't know each other that well, do you? Now, the hits just keep on coming. Here's a board meeting between Toronto's Lou Francischetti and Minnesota's Dave Gagne. Here it is on the replay from another angle. And Gagne goes flying. Buffalo's Scott Arneal says, Auntie M, where's Toto? Where's Toto? Where's Uncle Henry? There's no place like home. There's no place like home. I'll crawl home on my hands and knees just to end this silly segment. Let's test your knowledge of hockey once again. Here's our trivia question. Who scored the most points in one season as an NHL rookie? Put your thinking caps on. We'll come back with the answer in a few seconds. But first, you make the call. Is this puck in or not? Now, that's the way the goal judge looked at it. It was so fast. We don't know the call he made yet. We want you to make the call. Was the puck over the line or was it not? Darren Poopa of Buffalo was the goalie. Did he pull it back? You bet he did. If you said the puck was over the line, well, you made the right call. Congratulations. And now you know how tough it is being a goal judge. Now the answer to our trivia question. The question again. Who scored the most points in one season as an NHL rookie? Pretty good hockey player, came from Czechoslovakia. His name? Peter Stasny. 109 points for Quebec in 80-81. If you've ever played or watched the sport of hockey, you know that players will do almost anything in their passionate pursuit of the puck. And when I say almost anything, I mean almost anything. Now it's time for the kooky, crazy, nutty, wacko, madcap, zany, and sensational plays from hockey. Now, all throughout this video, you've seen some moments that naturally were a bit more exciting than others. Plays that deserve some kind of recognition, some kind of kudo, some kind of an award. And that's just what this segment's all about. I'm proud to be your host for the award-winning Hebsy Awards, the best that this video had to offer and more. Now, the Hebsies have a long and rich tradition. You know, back in the 1970s, athletes realized that if they did something wonderful or controversial or stupid or ridiculous, they'd likely find themselves on that evening's sportscast. Suddenly and without warning, players were committing bloopers, well, faster than the tape machines could roll. Naturally, we found out through exhaustive market research that people love to laugh and that we enjoy making people laugh. So get ready to have some real fun as we present the award-winning Hebsy Awards. And here they are, as promised, the Hebsy Awards' craziest coach, Calgary's Terry Crisp. A madman behind the bench. Best hit against the boards. Ally of Brady gets his helmet knocked off. Best move by the son of a former great, Brett Hull. Scores. Best acceptance of a collect phone call while working a game. Referee Denny Morrell. Best stick smash. Goalie Ron Hextall. Best impersonation of Hulk Hogan and Randy Macho Man Savage. These two guys, unidentified, trying to be wrestlers. Most disgusting fan in hockey history. This unidentified fan wiping the opponent's jersey. And if that isn't disgusting enough, he goes completely obscene by showing off his disgusting midriff. Best impersonation of a beached whale, L.A. goaltender Kelly Rudy, making snowmen. Toughest hit, Jimmy Mann, gets his face rearranged into the boards. Best coaches, Jock Demers, making sure his hair is on straight, fighting Herb Brooks. Come on, I dare you, hit me. Senior Wentzless impersonation, Pat Burns. Worst wave, these fans here, terrible. Funniest mascot, Yuppie. Worst goalmouth collision, Rick Walmsley and Zarly Zalapsky. Worst charging penalty, against the goalie, Jocelyn Lemieux, takes on Bill Ranford. Toughest collision between two little guys, Theron Fleury and Kelly Rudy. Best hit by a Leaf defenseman, Luke Richardson, on Montreal's Claude Lemieux. Best hit, ballet style, anybody that Wendell Clark takes on. Worst cheap shot, this hit on Lyndon Byers. Best celebration after a goal, Montreal's Russ Courtneau. Hey, I'm on the Hebsy Awards! I'm on the Hebsy Awards! I'm so excited, I made it on the Hebsy Awards! Best reappearance of a player in another team's bench, Jocelyn Lemieux, Chicago. Worst hit against the Hartford Whaler, this one on Paul McDermott. Ouch! Best revenge by a Hartford Whaler, Paul McDermott right here, involved in a train wreck against Montreal. Count the hits if you can. Best power forward, Hebsy loves Cam Neely of Boston. When he takes a man out, he takes him out. Worst elbow, Tom Laidlaw, Los Angeles. Ouch! Best disappearing act into another team's bench, Jocelyn Lemieux and Jeff Hookaboom. Biggest rivalry between two teams, Montreal and Boston. Every time they hit each other, somebody gets hurt or falls down, or both. Worst way to adjust your helmet, Bob Joyce, Boston. And finally, worst pass at a girl in the front row, Joe Riecke, Buffalo. Here's looking at you, babe.
You know, the greats of hockey will always be remembered for their accomplishments on and off the ice, their ability to score big goals, make big saves, win championships. But we have a soft spot in our hearts for guys like this, Dallas Smith, guys who put in their time, didn't win any awards, and were rarely remembered. These players are the heart and soul of Hockey Bloops, and we are happy to have them included in this video. Well, that's about it for me. What's that, 30 seconds? Another 30 seconds? What am I going to talk about? I've done everything that's asked of me. I got to get this tuxedo back in the window before 5, or they charge me for an extra day. I got to get out of here before someone catches me. See ya.